Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at how intelligent purging systems work to extract non-condensable gases from an industrial ammonia refrigeration system. Now, I just want to take a quick moment to thank Danfoss for sponsoring this video. When you're done watching this video, then I highly recommend that you check out their intelligent purging systems. Just click on the link in the video description down below. So if we look at a typical single-stage industrial ammonia refrigeration system, we have the compressor, which pushes the high-pressure ammonia vapor to the condenser. All the unwanted heat from the cooling space is removed from the refrigerant in the condenser, and that heat is then dispersed to atmosphere. As the heat is removed, the ammonia refrigerant condenses and converts into a liquid. This high-pressure liquid refrigerant then flows to the receiver and into the expansion valve. The receiver holds a quantity of liquid refrigerant in temporary storage and will release or accumulate refrigerant here to stabilize changes in the cooling demands on the system. There is an equalizing line between the receiver and the compressor discharge line, which, as the name suggests, equalizes the pressure between these two points in the system so that ammonia vapor can flow and therefore the liquid refrigerant level can vary. The expansion valve regulates the pressure and addition of liquid refrigerant into the evaporator circuit. From the expansion valve, the ammonia flows into the liquid separator. The liquid flows to the bottom, where a pump typically sucks in the refrigerant and sends this to the evaporator to provide cooling and collect the unwanted heat. The ammonia picks up the unwanted heat from the evaporator, and this will cause it to boil and evaporate. It leaves the evaporator and enters back into the liquid separator as a liquid vapor mixture. The refrigerant, which is liquid, falls down and repeats the cycle again. But the refrigerant, which is vapor, rises and will be sucked into the compressor suction line. This low-pressure vapor refrigerant is then compressed and sent around the system in a continuous cycle. So that's our basic industrial ammonia refrigeration cycle. We have covered this in much greater detail though in our previous video. Do check that out, links down below. Now in this system, we're going to get a buildup of non-condensable gases and air in two main locations. These will be at the top of the receiver above the liquid refrigerant and at the top of the drop leg of the outlet of the condenser. These gases and pockets of air will decrease the system's efficiency and therefore reduce the cooling capacity and increase the energy consumption. It is inevitable that air will get into the system, so we need to purge this to maintain optimal performance. So what we do is connect a purging unit to both the locations where the air and gases accumulate, and then we control access to these with solenoid valves. We also have another pipe connected back to the liquid line. This will act as a drain and return any ammonia which is collected during the filtering. Let's have a look inside the purging unit to see how one operates. I've just illustrated this a little different to make it easier to see. This part is our ammonia refrigeration system, and this part is the purging system. So as you can see, inside the purging unit we have another, separated and much smaller refrigeration system. We have a small compressor which is pushing a different refrigerant, in this case R452A, and this pushes it around the separate circuit. It flows to a small condenser with its own fan, which blows ambient air across the heat exchanger. The refrigerant then flows to a receiver. It then flows to an expansion valve and then into an evaporator and back around to the compressor. The evaporator is connected to the ammonia system, but the two systems are completely separated. The ammonia and the R452A never meet or mix. The controller signals for one of the solenoid valves to open, and it will start to vent the mixture of air, ammonia, non-condensable gases into the evaporator within the purging unit. Only one valve can open at a given time, because if both open, then the liquid refrigerant will rush in and flood the unit. Now we've covered how solenoid valves work in detail in a separate video, do check that out, links down below. So with one of the solenoid valves open, let's say the receiver tank valve for example, then the mixture of air, ammonia vapor and other gases is going to seep out of the receiver tank and into the evaporator of the purging unit. These vapors and gases will build up in the evaporator. The small refrigeration system is cycling the R452A refrigerant on the other side of the evaporator, and this will provide cooling to the gas mixture. The mixture will be cooled down below the condensing temperature of the ammonia. This causes just the ammonia to condense into a liquid. The air and gases will remain in gas form because their properties are different, and so their condensing temperatures are much lower. So the air and gases will remain in the evaporator while the ammonia turns into a liquid, and this will then flow back via gravity into the system through the drain line. As this occurs, it naturally draws in more air, ammonia, and vapor gas mixtures. This continues until the buildup of air and gases in the evaporator reaches a certain level. The controller detects that the evaporator temperature and pressure has changed as a result of the buildup. It will then open another solenoid valve on the vent line from the evaporator to discharge the buildup of air and gases. This allows the air and gases to flow away to an external water bath, which will wash out any residual ammonia which has been caught up. The process then repeats again and again, and we maintain the system at an optimal performance. Okay guys, that's it for this video, but to continue your learning, then check out one of the videos on screen now, and I'll catch you there for the next lesson. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, as well as theengineeringmindset.com.